Good day. So ngayon, we'll look at trigonometric integrals. So basically, we'll look at integrals na ang integrand ay trigonometric functions of a particular form. So meron lang tayo mga specific na forms na titignan at i-evaluate using some techniques of integration. Pero we'll start by looking at the 6 trigonometric functions at let's make sure na alam natin yung integrals na lahat. And right now, what we have are the integrals of sine x, which is equal to negative cosine x plus c, at yung integral ng cosine x, which is sine x plus c. So we're now ready to evaluate the integrals of the other trigonometric functions like tangent, cotangent, secant, and cosecant. So let's begin. So let's start with the integral of the tangent function. So integral of tangent x dx. Ang gagawin nating approach ay first, i-express natin siya as sine over cosine. So we're looking now for the integral of sine x over cosine x. And for this function, gagamitin natin yung substitution method. So we let u be equal to the denominator, cosine x. So necessarily, yung du niya ay negative sine x, dx. And happily, meron tayong sine x sa numerator. So ready na tayo agad mag-substitute. Using substitution, we could rewrite this, no? As well, kailangan natin ng negative sine x. So isusulat ko muna siya as negative sine x. At maglalagay ako ng negative sa labas para mag-cancel out dun sa requirement nating negative sine x para kay du. And now we're ready to perform our substitution. So we'll write it as negative 1 over u du, which we know na ang integral ng 1 over u is ln of the absolute value of u. And since u is equal to cosine x, diretso na natin siyang ipasok. So may negative sa labas. Ngayon, pwede na natin itong isulat, no, as our final answer, but we have to remember this identity na ang negative ln of x ay equal sa ln of 1 over x. Diba? Yung coefficients ng ln, pwede natin siyang i-transfer na exponent ng argument niya. So magiging raised to the negative 1, yung 1 over x. So para mas maganda yung pagsulat natin, gamitin natin to at isulat natin yung integral ni tangent x as ln of the absolute value of secant x plus c. So we have our first integral na hindi sine and cosine. So the integral of tangent x is this. Let me just write it down. Okay. Now let's move on dun sa next function. So we'll do the same approach for cotangent. And that means rewrite natin siya as cosine over sine naman this time. And the same method yung gagamitin natin. Substitution pa rin. But this time yung u natin is yung sine x na. So denominator pa rin. Pero nagpalit na yung denominator. So we let u be equal to sine x and du be equal to cosine x dx. Then same approach. I think we could proceed now with the substitution na 1 over u du. So the integral of 1 over u is ln of the absolute value of u. So mag-back substitute na rin tayo agad-agad. This is equal to ln of the absolute value of sine x. Siyempre, plus our constant of integration. And ito na yun. Ito na yung ating final answer for the integral of cotangent x dx. Moving on naman tayo kay secant. So we want to find the integral of secant x. So what we'll do is we will multiply this by 1 in a special way. What that means is mag-multiply ako ng something over something para lang equal siya sa 1 at wala siyang impact dun sa value ng integral. And yung imumultiply natin sa kanya ay secant x plus tangent x over secant x plus tangent x. So what we'll do is we'll distribute yung secant sa numerator. So we'll have to rewrite that as secant squared x plus secant x tangent x over secant x plus tangent x pa rin. At ngayon natin gagawin yung ginawa natin dun sa previous two functions. Now, when we do our substitution, our u is the denominator. Well, i-verify natin, no? Ang derivative ng secant ay secant x tangent x. Ang derivative ni tangent ay secant squared x. So, yun yung du natin, di ba? Secant x tangent x plus secant squared x dx. But take a look at that du. That is precisely the numerator. Magkaiba lang yung order ng terms. Proceed pa rin tayo sa 1 over u du. Ganun pa rin. And predictable na yung result, this is equal to the ln of the absolute value of u. And nag-back substitute na tayo, so yung u natin, secant x plus tangent x. So our final answer for the integral of secant x is the natural logarithm of the absolute value of secant x plus tangent x. I think you will expect na yung last function, si cotangent, ay magiging similar yung approach. So that should not be a surprise. So we'll still multiply 1 in a special way, meaning mag-multiply ako ng something over something. And ang imumultiply natin ay cosecant x minus cotangent x over cosecant x minus cotangent x. same approach, we will distribute yung cosecant x sa numerator. So we'll get cosecant squared x minus cosecant x cotangent x all over yung multiply natin na cosecant x minus cotangent x. And we will perform substitution na ang u ulit natin ay yung denominator. Let's verify this muna, no? Kukunin natin yung du. Ang derivative ng cosecant x ay negative cosecant x cotangent x. So okay, andun tayo. Minus cotangent x. Ang derivative ni cotangent x ay negative cosecant squared x. So minus negative. So ang mangyayari dun sa du natin, we can rewrite it as cosecant squared x minus cosecant x cotangent x para mauna yung positive na term. And that is precisely the numerator nung integrand natin na bago. So again, this will be the integral of 1 over u du. So predictable result, this is still the ln of the absolute value of u. Pero ang u natin ay yung cosecant x minus cotangent x. So ln of the absolute value of cosecant x minus cotangent x plus c, that is equal to the integral of cosecant x. And now we're able to complete our table. So ito na yung anim na trigonometric functions and their integrals. So on our next video, we'll take a look at specific forms naman ng sine and cosine and how to evaluate their integrals. For now, salamat sa pakikinig.